Hi, I'm George Pearson. In this Adobe Photoshop video, we'll be taking this line drawing of a person here, first removing out all of these light blue construction lines, just like that, and then removing the white background from the black lines, separating those two, giving you complete freedom on how you want to use the drawing. Now, if you like this video, make sure you click that like button and, of course, share it with your friends. Hit that subscribe button as well so you don't miss it on any future videos. And to learn a lot more about Photoshop, take a look at my complete training course, and you'll find a link right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. Here we are at the original line drawing. As you can see here, it has some nice ink work in here, but the ink work has kind of a green tint to it. We have these nice light blue non-photo lines in here, construction lines, to help with the original drawing. And all of this, as you can see, of course, is just sitting on the background layer over here. And the first thing I always do is simply to copy the background layer to a new layer. This is just a safety. I'll just take this, drag it down to the new layer button right there, make a copy, and hide the original. That way, if I do anything by accident to mess this up during my work here, I can always go back to my original, which is right there saved in this file. So that's a very good habit to be in. Okay, here we are. Now the first thing we need to do is to get rid of these light blue construction lines. And that's pretty easy to do. We'll go up to Image, come down to Adjustment, and then come down to Replace Color. We'll basically be replacing those light blue lines with white. So Replace Color. Here we go. Now I have my fuzziness set for about halfway up the slider control. That will just help you get all the different shades of this particular light blue. Now just take the eyedropper, using the one right up here, upper left hand corner, come down and find a nice spot of that blue. This is kind of a nice clean spot in here. I'll just click in this, and looks like we've done a good job now of capturing all of that. There's the result, just kind of a nice light blue color right there. Let's now take the lightness setting and move this all the way to the right, and that should just about clean out all of those construction lines. Let's move our saturation clear to the left as well, just as a final little touch, and that should take care of that. So we've simply converted those light blue lines to white. There's still some other drawn lines in here, but those aren't part of the light blue. That's part of the initial pencil line work in there. We can minimize that as well. So first step, simply replace that light blue or convert that to a good white. Choose OK, and we've cleaned up that step. Let's now convert this to a pure black and white to push this kind of a green tone into a black tone. Go up again to Image, come down to Adjustments, and then black and white. There we go. Of your options up here, since we had that blue in there, I'm going to use the blue filter just to help push things a little bit further towards the black and get rid of any of that blue that was remaining in there, and choose OK. So we've now converted this to a straight black and white. At this point, we can play around with the contrast and push the contrast as much as possible. And we'll do that using Levels, back over here to Image, Adjustments, and Levels right here. There we go. Now in here you can see the black point right there and your white point right over here. Any of these little drawn lines in here, these are coming in as gray values. So I'm first going to bring up the black, just punch it up, and put my slider right in the middle of my main black. So you can see where it's really peaking right there. That just guarantees that the main black values are a pure black. Now to minimize these drawn lines, take your gray slider, and if you move it to the left, notice how those just kind of disappear in there. Also, if you take your white slider on the right-hand side and move that in, you can help those to disappear. So it's kind of a balancing act between this slider and this slider. So take this one, keep this as far as you can to the right before you begin seeing those lines. If you watch right down here on his leg, you can already see those coming in right there. Let us back off just a bit on that and punch my white up a bit, get a nice clean white. And by balancing these two out, we can have a nice rich black and minimize any of those drawn lines that are in there. So a little bit right up here in the forehead, so I can back off a bit on this and kind of lose that as well. Now this will also tend to lose some of your real thin pen and ink lines, so just be careful of that. You may want to have a balance in here. I personally like to have a little bit of those additional drawing lines showing, so I might come up just a bit, but there's a bit right up here above the head. I don't want that, so I'm going to push my white to the left and just minimize that. There we go. And that's about the best we can get with this control, but we're really, really close. Anything else you can fine-tune later on with just an eraser and just kind of clean that out. But there we go. We've taken out the blue, and we've also taken out pretty much all of those pencil sketch lines and left in just our ink lines. And again, it's just kind of a balancing act in here to get exactly the right amount. And I think maybe somewhere in here looks pretty good. Right about like that. Okay, now don't take these locations as being set in stone. This really is one of those things you have to look at your drawing and then move these around to find the right point. Your black should be right in the middle of your main blacks down here, and the white and the gray values, adjust these until you're removing those little fine lines you may not want to have in any longer. Once that's done, just choose OK, and that step's done. Now all we have left is simply to remove the background from the black lines, and that's actually very easy to do once we've taken it to this point. Move over here to your Channels tab. Here's all of our channels, as you can see here. It's all black and white, so these really aren't doing anything for us. They're just kind of all combined together. Go straight down to the bottom, and there's a little button right down there, and this loads the channel as a selection. It takes all the stuff and loads it as a selection. What this actually does is it selects the white and leaves out the black. That's what that button does for you down there. So we now have our white selected. Let's go back to our layers again. We want the black selected and not the white, so we have to invert our selection. Go up to Select, come down to Inverse, and now the black is selected. Let's make a new layer. There we go. New layer right here. We have our selection. Now all it's left to do is just to fill that selection with black. So we'll go up here to Edit, come down to Fill, and set your contents here to black. Everything else stays the same. Choose OK, and that's done. We can now just deselect this. Go up to Select and deselect, and there it is. If I hide that layer, we now no longer have that attached to our background. Let's come here. This, of course, is our working layer. Let's put a new layer above that, layer two. So this layer one, this is our black lines. Let's call that one black lines. This layer is going to be a pure white background. Let's just fill it with white. Make sure your colors here are set on white foreground. Just go to your default colors and invert that. Paint bucket and fill it with white. And there we are. So we now have the nice line drawing all cleaned up and the black lines separated from the white. So let's just get rid of that. There is our cleaned up version. There's the original. There's a cleaned up version. And there it is with the white and the black separated out as individual layers. So there you go. That's how you can remove the white background from a line drawing, just like that. Now that the black lines are separated out from the white background, you can easily do any coloration you want by simply putting in layers underneath the black. Let's just put a new layer right here. There we go. And I'll grab some kind of a blue color in here, maybe like that, and paintbrush. You can see now that the color is underneath of the black, giving you complete freedom to colorize your image any way you want without harming or damaging your black lines. And since your coloring will all be on its own separate layer or layers, you can show or hide that as needed, and even remove the color just by deleting a color layer. There you go. Don't forget to check out my complete Photoshop training course, and again, you'll find a link for that right down there in the description. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future.
I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.